Mega Iron Truth with me. Today we're doing another mailbag. So we're going to get right to it, right to these questions. First question comes from Joaquin Cintron, and he writes, who are the best Latin American fighters of all time?
It's tough to find.
Tough question.
That means they're born in America, but raised in another country, country.
Well, it's that they're Latin people,
okay.
That their ethnicity is Latin or Hispanic or something like that. Tough to find Latin American in that sense. But the three I came up with, that we've kind of come up with, Johnny Tapia, Oscar De La Hoya, Fernando Vargas.
Yeah, that's top three, definitely.
Johnny Tapia, all his wars down at Featherweight.
And Bantamweight.
Featherweight, all the, really good fighter, really good guy.
Yeah.
Really like him in and outside of the ring.
Definitely.
Just a class act. He's had quite a lack. Quite an interesting life.
Yeah, been through a lot.
Came out of a coma, went into a coma first of all,
yeah.
And don't know if it was drug induced, don't know what kind of coma it was, but
I think that one was where he fell and hit his head on the floor or something like that.
But
maybe.
In a coma, and coma is clearly serious business.
Yeah. Came out and fought again after
fought
that.
Fought again somehow.
So.
And won some fights after the coma.
Okay.
I mean, now, the last couple years, it's clear he needs to retire. It is clear he needs to retire. He lost to Sandro Marcos. When you lose to him, it's
got knocked
retire.
Out by him, too.
Knocked
and he'd
out
never
by
been
a
knocked
body
out.
Punch.
Yeah, and he'd never been knocked out before, even come close to
it. It wasn't even that great of a shot, really. It was from Sandro Marcos. How could it have been? But, just wasn't that good of a shot. And it's Tapia. I think you're an excellent all-time fighter. But it's time to.
Yeah.
Go away. Head on into the sunset.
One of the best bantamweights ever, definitely.
I'd love you to go into training or something like that.
Yeah, training.
Promoting.
He'd
be a good, promoter as far as his
not screwing
charisma.
Fighters. Yeah, definitely.
He could really, he's got a very likable personality. Everyone likes Johnny Tapia. They're supposed to make a movie about him.
Yeah.
That's been talked about for years, actually. And he would have a very interesting movie.
Yes.
But anyhow, Johnny Tapia, also, of course, Oscar De La Hoya, you can't deny that he is an excellent fighter. And his lightweight career when he started, unbelievable.
Yeah.
And that was back when he looked a lot less
like he does now. Yeah,
truthfully. He looked a lot...
Looked harder. Looked like he was from the streets.
Tougher or something. I don't know. He just...
You could believe he was from where he actually
didn't,
is.
He didn't have that polished sort of... sort of vague look to him that he has kind of
put
himself
now,
on now, this persona he does now, the Golden Boy.
Yeah.
He was an amazing lightweight and great welterweight, of course, also.
Yeah. And junior middleweight went up and beat Vargas.
Actually went up and fought Bernard Hopkins.
Yeah,
I mean, he did lose to him, but he went up and fought him. A lot of guys wouldn't have done that.
No.
So
he's fought everybody, and now he's fighting Mayweather.
Absolutely fighting Mayweather. He cannot be accused of ducking anyone.
Never.
He wasn't wanting to fight Fernando Vargas at first, but that was partially because Vargas, very experienced.
Yeah, wasn't the big name yet.
And wasn't a big name yet. I mean, he was a big enough name, but... Not for what De La Hoya was wanting, for some kind of super fighter.
And then De La Hoya was playing mind games with
that, of course.
He pulled out of the fight originally.
De La Hoya doing his trickery before fights, which has already started with the Mayweather fight.
Yeah.
And anyhow, still all-time great fighter, definitely. There's no way to deny that. And also, for great Latin American fighters, I'd say Fernando Vargas. One of the youngest phenoms to come into the sport and take it by storm, beating guys when he was taking some of these fights when he was like 15, 16-0.
The youngest middleweight, the youngest junior middleweight champion ever, 21 years old, beat Yuri Boy Campos, dominated him.
Dominated Yuri Boy Campos. Yeah. This was when Campos was...
Still very good. In his prime.
Very good.
Yeah.
I mean...
And just beat him over eight rounds. beat the hell out of
him. Campus had, what, about 70 fights at that point? Yeah. 70 victories?
And his only loss was the Trinidad fight.
Yeah.
So he still only had the one loss. And also, Vargas beat Winky Wright and Ike Corte in back-to-back fights. That right there is amazing, especially at that young of an age.
Yep, that young of an age. So, absolutely amazing that Wright didn't just embarrass him with his boxing.
And Vargas did beat him.
Yep.
A lot of people say Wright won. I disagree completely. Vargas did clearly win that fight.
Also, now, Wright would most likely win today. I don't see Vargas winning today, honestly. But still a great fighter. He hasn't looked good in recent years. He's had his moments, but whenever he stepped up, he hasn't looked good. He looked great against De La Hoya the first half
rounds
of the fight.
Yeah. Doing great, knocked him down in the first round. Wasn't counted, but knocked him back up against the ropes, and De La Hoya's glove touched the ground.
And he was saved by the ropes. Had the ropes not been there, he would have been on the floor.
Absolutely. And Vargas just came out. He stayed too composed. He didn't let his hands go enough. He should have.
Yep.
He was trying to show he could box with him, which
that was obviously a
mistake.
That was not a good strategy for Vargas.
No.
He's not a boxer.
No.
He just is not. And anyhow, Vargas,
hopefully he does come back and do something at middleweight.
So. I really don't think he has much longer left, truthfully. I just really don't see him doing a lot more at this point. I hope he does, but I don't really see him doing a lot more. Just, he's really taken some beatings now.
Trinidad, De La Hoya, and mostly
Trinidad
twice.
Trinidad especially.
Yeah.
Trinidad just really hurt Vargas a lot.
I messed him up.
Basically, he didn't ruin his career, but he definitely
didn't help it.
He definitely took a lot away from it.
That started Vargas' downside, definitely.
Probably took about 5-6 years off of Vargas' career in that one fight.
Yeah.
Vargas way too young, just like David Reed was way too young. Both these guys were way too young when they fought Trinidad.
Vargas,
their promoter should not have let them fight him at that point.
Vargas at least had very good quality wins and was a champion. Well, David Reed was a champion also, but Vargas did have
also.
Vargas had much better opposition at the time that he took on Trinidad than David Reed.
And he had absolutely. And
but still too early.
Still
too early.
I mean, this was Trinidad.
Yeah.
This guy was a monster, unstoppable.
Always in the top 3 or 4 pound for pound.
And they had already seen what happened to David Reed.
Yeah. And Vargas, of course, thought he could beat him. Somehow he got out of the first round. Still don't know how he did that.
He put up a decent fight.
Absolutely.
Somehow.
One of the best fights I've seen ever.
Yeah, and that leads into our next question. Thank you, Joaquin Cintron, for writing this.